Dakari and Josh, of course, earned the right to get a break. Just the way they played last game.
Dwayne Bacon with the opening bucket in Orlando, Florida.
We talked about Graham. I think it's amazing to see the comfort in just the players' demeanor as they move into their second year of summer league or season in general.
They get it to Gills, just 3 of 11 here in summer league so far. Didn't get a shot off there. OKC moves it ahead. Marcus Page, lefty three. That shot has looked really good here. He hasn't taken a ton of them, but
yes, he has a great-looking shot.
Three-point range, very small sample here in Orlando. And again, that's not really his game, but he's going to have to do it. Hunter cuts to the rim, and Vince Hunter with an and-one opportunity.
Oh, no.
That doesn't minimize how difficult the decision it is. I'm sure he feels loyalty to his teammates in Utah.
Right. And that we love chooses otherwise.
Sure.
But I think for him, like Kevin Durant and every other player, my guy Marcus Page is a big-time three here. It just depends on what he wants. And, you know, we have to, as fans and players and everybody else who are watching and waiting, we have to kind of respect his decision.
Circumvent that whole idea.
Exactly.
By taking a shorter deal and ultimately getting all the money that they possibly could.
Yeah.
Or in Durant's case, deciding to leave a little on the table, apparently.
Right. In the NBA setting now. Well, starting to get comfortable.
Marcus Page is almost always going to be the point guard, whatever team he's on, and he continues to tear it up from three-point range. 6 of 7 now here in Orlando. He did, yeah.
Ooh.
Broke his streak. He's only 6 of 8 from three-point range now. Got that little mid-range thing going.
Yes, sure does.
Away by Page. He'll try it again. Page digs down. Graham tees up the three, and it's good. Double team. Hamilton to the left hand. Beautiful finish by Daniel Hamilton.
Very nice. Yes, it
46 is games there, 12 points. Shot under 40% from the field, 35% from three, so this is not normal for him. Gabe York beats the buzzer.
You saw there, the Knicks only had 4
That's
points.
Not good.
It's not good.
Mango Mathiang. Flying in for the big finish. Hold up, tried the three. Here's Gabe York in the open floor. York bumps into Thornton. Good body control by Gabe York to finish. Gabe York has 2 very impressive buckets here.
Right.
About a 35-footer to end the first quarter. Great block by Mathiang. Corbett pulls up from 18, and it's pure.
Very nice.
This pro team in Indonesia. But as we've said before, if you're averaging 25 anywhere, you know how to score. You know what
Absolutely.
You're doing. Here's Gill. Easy bucket. That'll get it going.
Much needed points for Gill. I was going to match that anyway.
Well, you never know. The teams always say, we're going to match.
Right.
Right?
Because,
of course, you would publicly.
Yeah.
And one here for OKC.
They'll make the sacrifice and bring him back.
I think they will as well. The question is, what are they going to do?
At
what price and what do they do about their bench? Off the floor, bench was not productive, even with Bogdanovich, who can really shoot the basketball. Even without, with Brandon Jennings on the floor. And back the other way come the Thunder. Dylan Ennis knocks down the three.
Extremely hard. Plays extremely hard. Shoots the ball very well. I remember watching him in the tournament play. Very good play. Another offensive rebound.
We get another try at it. Chris Joseph for 3. And a productive possession for the Charlotte Hornets.
Man.
It was, what, a 6-point possession?
Yeah.
Marin with the dunk on the other end. Hit by Weber. A free throw by Marin. And then the 3-pointer. Treveon Graham.
What Canadian basketball is doing and producing players now, definitely. Hats off to the program. It's great to see.
But Joseph's feeling it now a little bit. He got that free throw and then knocked down a 3. Was comfortable on that one, and they get the offensive putback. 30 seconds to go here in the second quarter. Weber, 2-for-1 chance. Executed perfectly. In points with a bucket in the second half.
You know, it's interesting what Coach said about Dwight as far as how he wants to use him, and they still believe.
There aren't many head coaches who would allow him to take it very often.
Right.
Because you want him in pick and roll, and you want him near
for
the
sure.
rim.
Because he's a great screener. He's a great roller. He draws a lot. Looks are just not falling for him.
pull-up three-pointer.
Good-looking shot.
And Dylan had it. Lost the handle there. Graham has it with 4 seconds on the shot clock. Puts it up and in. Treveon Graham now with 15 points for the Hornets. Bacon, three is short. But that mid-range is pure for Dwayne Bacon.
Put him through, knowing Coach. There again, Coach is going to have those guys passing with him, getting them up.
That is a rare four-on-one, and Anthony Gill keeps it himself.
May feel he should play more minutes. And that's just the tough thing about being a rookie playing on a good team when you think you should play. Still have Jay Crowder.
Right.
You have a lot of guys that can play the 3-4 position.
Already Jaylen Brown in front of him, who was great last night.
Yeah, he's forward. I mean, do you want to continue to keep getting draft picks, or do you use some of these picks for? I think he's very important to their team because of his two-way ability.
He's got free agency coming up next summer.
Right.
Dwayne Bacon brings it up for the Hornets. 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. O'Brien for three. Got it.
To where they will compete, and they will make it tougher for the Cleveland Cavaliers. We don't know if they'll beat them. That remains to be seen. But
you never
now
know.
They can compete.
Put themselves, A, in position to compete with Cleveland.
Yes.
But just as importantly, not only in position to compete with Cleveland, as Mathiang hits a nice little turnaround left-hander. Future.
For sure.
With the possibility that perhaps the Cavaliers aren't looking exactly the same a year from now.
Right.
Depending on what LeBron James decides to do.
For sure. They're definitely in the hunt. I mean, we knew they were in the running for, you know, a run in the playoffs again.
These NBA executives and scouts here are all interested that Gordon Hayward reportedly is headed to the Celtics. Here's Corbin behind the back. He's really solid.
Man, he has a nice mid-range game. Jump shot looks great.
Mentioned it in the first half, just a really confident-looking point guard. Guy knows, seems to know what he's doing out there. Once again, they get a switch. They get a mismatch down low. Haven't recognized it. Dylan Ennis handles with that shock of blonde in his hair and sets up Rashawn Thomas.
Very nice player.
Mathiang out top just had it taken away by Thomas. That's going to be a clear path foul. And one. Corbin pops for three. Wow. Tyrell Corbin.
Impressed with his game right now. He's doing it all.
Well, Hunter didn't get a shot, but he runs the floor really well.
And
Morin. Hamilton saw Mathiang in the open floor and worked him over. Mathiang down low. Mismatch, easy bucket.
Great pass.
The plot thickens.
Yes, it does.
Hamilton up to Hunter. Alley-oop.
Nice. In summer league would score in that game, and they did.
All right, I'm going with it then. Hunter again running the floor, and Vince Hunter making things happen for OKC. And that's what Charlotte has to work with as they inbound. Weber spins. O'Brien tries another three. Got it. Hamilton ran into Bacon, absorbs the contact, and gets the bucket to go. Nice strength by Daniel Hamilton. Graham puts it on the floor. Back out to Weber. Wiped away by Hunter. But it falls back into the hands of Treveon Graham.